This is a part 3 of my SwiftUI for iOS 15 course, and we're going to cover a lot of things. First, there's the new searchable, where we're going to build a custom UI in which we can search a term and get auto-suggestions, as well as being able to select the view and go to that view using a modal sheet. Then we're going to learn how to create a custom modal system in which we have a custom button style with control size, and also we're going to animate these fields so that the circle is going to transition based on the position. We'll cover the new markdown support in iOS 15 so that we can create rich text styles and open links easily in Safari. The modal is going to have gestures in which you can drag in both directions, and it's going to rotate as well as have a 3D perspective, and you're going to be able to dismiss the modal. Now, the modal system is going to switch between screens, and when you're signed in, it's going to remember and it's going to go to the account screen. In the account screen, we're going to learn about the async await feature in which we can run functions asynchronously. This is great for API calls so that you don't want to freeze your app while you're waiting for a response. And also we're going to use the new refreshable so that we have a built-in pull to refresh, and you can see that the data here has changed. Now we're going to add a little feature called the light mode, which allows us to focus on performance, which means that we can enable or disable drop shadows and some heavy graphics. At the same time, we're going to test the performance, look at the CPU usage, the memory, the disk, as well as the network calls. Finally, we're going to cover the accessibility so that we can make sure that VoiceOver is going to work and what are some of the best practices for text as well as images and other elements. So at the end of part 3, we're going to build the rest of the screens, even though some of it I'm going to test your knowledge to make sure you're building on your own instead of always following me, and then we can compare the final code together. But most importantly, we're going to wrap things up and we're going to make sure that we have exactly the same app at the end of this course. So I hope you're excited. We have a lot of materials to cover, and I'm going to do my best to explain all the steps in between. Let's get started. Let's start by creating a new view for the search. So we're going to go to Views and New File. It's going to be called Search View. Next, we're going to embed this inside a navigation view. So let's embed first navigation view. So this is necessary to make the new searchable work. Now for the content, we're going to embed this inside a list. For now, we're going to have 5 results. Then let's add a navigation title on the list. So navigation title, and it's going to be search. So there's a new searchable modifier for creating a search experience, and we're going to put that on the list. So searchable, and the text is going to use a binding. For this value, we're going to create at state var text is equal to empty text by default. And then we're going to bind that using $text. With this done, if you click play, you're going to be able to see the search field, but only when you scroll up. Please know that in my preview version, I'm not able to enter anything in the search field. You will be able to do that in the simulator, and maybe this is going to be fixed in a future version of Xcode. But for now, this is what we have. Next, let's talk about customizations. So by default, you're going to see that it's not going to show the search field. But you can set the display mode by setting right after the text placement.navigationDrawer, parentheses, and then display mode, dot, and now we have the option to set to always. When you do that, you're going to see the search field, but when we scroll down, it's going to transition to the large title back and forth. If you don't like to see that, you can always set navigation bar title display mode to inline, which means that it's not going to transition back to the large title. Another thing that you can customize is the placeholder text here, and we're going to put that right after placement. Prompt text parentheses. A good practice for this is what Apple likes to use, which is to suggest terms using comma. So Swift UI, React, UI design. All right, it would be a good idea to test this in the simulator. And in order to do that, we're gonna go to the navigation bar and we're going to use a sheet modal presentation. So for that, we're going to set a state var show search is equal to false by default. Then we're gonna scroll down a little bit to find the magnifying glass. And here we're going to embed the image inside a button. So button. The first parentheses are for the action, and we're going to set the label, which is the image itself. For the action, set show search is equal to true. And then we're going to set dot sheet modifier to call the modal presentation. So we're going to select is presented. The binding is $ show search. We're not going to need undismiss. And for the content, just press enter. And now we're going to show the search view that we just created, parentheses. Let's run this. From the home screen, when we tap on search, it's going to open the search view that we're creating. I can type in the field, but it's not really doing anything. Back in Xcode, let's head back to search view. Let's restructure the list a little bit so that we have more control. So lists is only going to use parentheses. And for the loop, we're going to select the text. Select repeat. The for each is going to use the course's data. And for the item data that we receive, let's set item.title. Now the goal here is to be able to filter the search results based on the term that we're typing here. So what you can do is to set for the course's data dot filter parentheses, then inside $0. Now, this is the equivalent of the first value that we received. So instead of setting item in, we would set $ and we don't need anything else. So it makes it a lot shorter. From that value, set dot title dot contains parentheses text. What this means is that we're going to filter the courses based on each value title that contains the text, which is a state from searchable. And just with that, you can see that we have zero results by default. That's because we haven't entered anything. But let's say we enter Swift UI, you can see that it filters to Swift. If you don't like to have empty results when you enter nothing, we can set after the parentheses pipe symbol, which looks like a long vertical line. We're going to do that twice. And this essentially means or text double equal signs, empty double quotes. So again, this means that either we filter based on the search term or nothing, and then it's going to show the results. So that's how you set a super simple search experience with filter. Now, before we get into the search suggestions, I want to add a close button so that I can dismiss this sheet modal presentation. So let's set at environment parentheses backward slash dot presentation mode var presentation mode. Using this environment variable, we're going to be able to dismiss the modal. For the button itself, since we're using a navigation bar, we can add dot navigation bar items. And here we have the option for leading, trailing, or one of them. So we're going to use trailing. Then we're going to set button, curly braces, label, and then curly braces again. For the label, it's simply going to be a text, quotes, done. Let's make that bold. And for the action, we're going to use the environment variable, which is presentation mode dot wrap value dot dismiss parentheses. Thanks to this, when you go to the search view, you see that I can scroll and we have a button inside the navigation bar. And when I click on it, it's going to dismiss the modal. Next, while we're here, we might as well go back to navigation bar and take care of the second button, which is the account button. So we're going to wrap this inside a button first, set the action, and then the label. For the action, let's set show account is equal to true. Show account is not set yet, so let's go to the top and set a state var show account is equal to false. Then let's not forget to set the sheet for the account. Right after the button dot sheet is presented $ show account. Again, we don't need to dismiss, and the content, press enter, account view, parentheses. Let's go to account view and do exactly the same thing as the search view, set at environment, parentheses, backward slash, presentation mode, var presentation mode. On the list, we're also going to set navigation bar items, trailing, doing exactly the same thing for the button, label, text, done, set it to bold, and for the action, presentation mode dot wrap value dot dismiss parentheses. So that's it. We have the search view and we can filter the results, and we can also dismiss the search view. Then the account button is now connected to the account view, and we can also dismiss that view. So in the next session in the search view, I want to show you how to set suggestions while you type. And this is a really useful and common search feature, like what you have in the App Store search. And it's really easy to do in iOS 15. So I'll see you in the next session.